Sniper Stalingrad 1942, a solo game, a solo micro game which only uses 9 cards. Alright, so let's just go with the turn. So one card is not played, I draw 2. And let's see here. Alright, no Germans on the board. Alright, I'm gonna set this as my setup. This will activate some Germans because I need some reinforcements. I'm hoping for the second officer which I can kill. Alright, I have 2 bullets, which means 2 attacks, 1 focus and 3 supplies. I have my ally soldier here and I'm on the open ground. Anyway, we have reinforcements on the 2. So let's see what will spawn. Oh, it's a normal soldier. This soldier will activate. Interesting. I didn't expect this. So the soldier is gonna activate, gonna go move toward the closest red point. Alright, so the closest red point is this one here. So soldiers move 2 spaces. Let's move 1, 2. And he's gonna be on top of the our ally soldiers, so they're gonna kill each other out. Alright. So I lost my ally. Then the tanks gonna activate, they're gonna move toward the closest yellow space. In this case, this space. They usually have 3 movement, but if they reach the destination, that's it. Alright. So the tank's gonna move here, which is pretty close to me. Okay, all enemy forces have additional -1 to strength if they are on the open ground. So I think I will retreat. So I have 3 supplies. Let me see. 1, 2, 3. I can hide in this building, but I'm actually gonna retreat back. So we're going 1, 2, 3. Hide in the building. And no use shooting the tank because I can't destroy it anyway. So let's discard these 2 and draw other 2. Okay, I definitely don't want the tank to activate, so I'm gonna use this as my setup. And this for the German attack. So the enemy is gonna be alerted. Reinforcements 2. So we got the sniper here. Oh, this is alright. This is actually not that bad. So all soldiers, officers and generals gonna activate, but we don't have any. We have only sniper and the tank right now. So I'm free to do whatever I want. So I have 1 shot, I can sustain 1 wound, and I have a focus and 2 supplies. I think I'm gonna move once, I'm gonna use 1 supply, and I'm gonna shoot at the sniper. Because if I manage to kill this sniper, I'm gonna get my reinforcements again. Because whenever you kill 3 snipers, you get reinforcements. Also, whenever you get a officer, you also get a reinforcement, but since only 1 token, you can't get too much reinforcements during the game. Alright, so I have a Molotov cocktail, but the tank is too far away. I have a focus die, but no, I'm not gonna attack the tank, I'm gonna attack this sniper. So let's try, but if I don't manage to kill him from the first shot, he's gonna retaliate. The good for me is I actually have this heart, which means I can sustain 1 damage, so that would be okay. Alright, shooting at the sniper. Ooh, this cancelled all the range between him and me, and this 6 is enough to kill him. So sniper is dead, I get the reinforcements back. And that worked really, really well for me. Alright. I'm still waiting for that officer. We discard 1 card, draw 2. I'm gonna take this as an activation, because I really want, if the officer come out from the reinforcement too, he will be so close I could be able to kill him immediately. But if the soldier, well, there is no any more soldiers, so I'm safe. Alright, so I have 3 shots, I have a focus and 1 supply. Let's do reinforcements too. Oh, that's a sniper. But he will not activate. Again, I have a Molotov cocktail. Alright, so since I have a focus, I'm just gonna move back a bit. And since there are 2 spots of range between me and this sniper right now has a 6 strength. But still, I had 3 shots. I think I can kill it. So first shot. Okay, 1, I don't need to reroll the focus because with the 1 I can't kill him. Second shot. Ooh, that's 6. Which will kill him before he activates. So the sniper is gone. Well, that was good. Go to the next round. Oh, I still have 2 more cards. Okay, let's see. Okay, I'm gonna use this as a setup. I'm gonna play this. So we're gonna have a reinforcement on spot 1, and it's the officer. Now, the soldier's gonna activate, the sniper's gonna activate, we don't have any, only tanks left. The tank's gonna move 3 spaces toward our base. So the closest route is, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Well, any. I can move like this or like this. Well, since I can choose, I think I'm gonna move him this way. So he's gonna move 3 spots. 1, 2, 3. He's gonna end on the open ground here. Okay, I have a hidden danger, which means all Soviet forces have +1 to strength if they're in the buildings. And I have 2 supplies. If I move with my sniper, 1, 2, there will be 2 range between me and the officer, and his strength is gonna be 7, which I can't get on a d6. So I'm gonna actually move my ally soldier, I'm gonna move it toward the tank. So 1, 2 supplies is gonna be in the buildings. Alright. I just need some cards to bring that officer a bit closer to me and kill him. So this is discarded, we have 2 cards. Oh, this will actually move the officer toward me. So I'm gonna use this as a setup and this as an activation. So soldiers, snipers, we don't have them, but we have an officer who's gonna move toward the closest blue spot, which is this. Officers move once. Oh, focus, you have 1 free reroll of the focus die. This is good, since I do have a focus die. Okay, 2 supplies, I think. Alright. So, if I kill a tank, I'm gonna get my reinforcement back. So I'm gonna actually spend a supply, both of supplies, to move a soldier twice. They're gonna kill each other, so the soldier's gonna destroy the tank. And since I did kill the tank, I'm gonna get my reinforcement back, which is pretty good. And then I'm gonna try 1 long shot. If I get that special symbol on the die, if I roll a 6 on the focus die, and I have 1 free reroll, so let's try. 4 is not enough to kill this GMM officer, because I need 5 or more, so I'm not gonna reroll the focus die. I had only 1 chance, I blew it. Alright. But still, I destroyed the tank. So let's see what we have here. I'm gonna use this as a setup. Because I really want this officer to come a bit closer. Well, actually, he's not gonna come closer to me. You know what? I'm actually gonna use this as a setup. And this as activation. So we're gonna have reinforcement on spot 1. And this is the last token, so that's a Panzer tank. There are no more tokens, so there will be no more reinforcements until I kill the officer. When all these tokens gonna get back, except the officer, and we also get the general on the side. Okay, rough terrain. All German units have -1 to movement till the end of this turn. Well, which means the tank's gonna move only twice toward the nearest red space. So 1, 2, tank's gonna be here. Then, enemies alerted. I have 2 supplies and I have 3 bullets. I think, and I don't have a focus die. So if I come here, only if I get a 6 I can kill an officer. But I have 3 shots. So I'm gonna spend 2 supplies to move closer. I don't need to worry about spawn points anymore. Nothing's gonna spawn anymore. I just need to kill that officer. Alright, I don't have a focus die, so only 6 on the dice can actually kill officer. I have 3 tries, so let's try. Attack number 1. No. Attack number 2. Yes, I got a 6. So the officer, which has a strength of 6, is dead. Now, whenever you kill the officer, you get a reinforcement, but I since I already have reinforcements on the ground, I don't get a new one, because you have only 1 that you can use token to roll the game. But now, we go to the second stage. First of all, these officers are removed. We put the general inside the bag and all of these tokens inside the bag. We shuffle the bag and we are ready to go to stage 2. Now, if I kill the general, which will come from some reinforcements, I win the game. This is... I never was close to winning like this before. This is a really good game for me right now. Okay, we discard 1. Good. Alright, I'm gonna actually use this as setup. And this... because I'm hoping that the general is gonna come out and get closer to me. Although, I'm not sure. wait a bit. I'm standing pretty close to the ring... spawn point 2, and if the general actually come out, he's gonna go to the closest yellow spot. Since the generals move only 1 space, he's gonna be on top of me, he's gonna capture me and kill me. So I'm actually gonna use this as my setup and this as an activation. I have to, because I can't risk if the general jumps on me instead of killing him, he's gonna capture me. Sorry. So, we don't have any soldiers or snipers, but we do have a tank. So, tank's gonna move toward the spawn point. So, the closest 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, yeah. He's gonna move this way, and he moves 3 spaces. So, 1, 2, and he will have to stop here, because tanks can't end their movement on the buildings. So this is the far it has gone. Also, all solid forces have additional +1 strength when they are in the housing. Well, they're not. I forgot to add reinforcements, man. Sorry. Ooh, okay. Before moving this tank, I will have to apply the bombardment. Because I should pull a reinforcement first and then move the units. So we have a bombardment, which is pretty bad, because me is on the open ground, reinforcements is on the open ground, and tank is on the open ground. So all 3 units right now can actually be killed. So let's start rolling. So let's start with our reinforcements first. Let's hope for 2 or 1 on the dice. Yes, the bombardment didn't kill my reinforcements. Now let's do the tank. The tanks can't be destroyed anyway, I'm just gonna roll, because it has a strength 7, and this is only d6. But now, here's the problem. Still, not a big problem, because I have 1 wound I can manage to survive. So even if I roll 6, which would kill me, I'm actually gonna lose a heart. Wow, that was pretty close. If I didn't have a heart to survive this one wound, I would actually be dead right now. Alright. At least I don't need to worry about bombardments anymore. Now the tank's gonna move. So 1, 2. Can't move into buildings. And then I have 3 supplies. I think I'm gonna move away. 1, 2. And move my Soviet soldier for 1. So I spent 2 supplies to move myself and 1 supply to move my allies out of the base. And I can shoot, but really I can't destroy the tank, so let's just continue. So 2 new cards. Okay, I'm gonna use this one because I have 2 attacks, focus and 3 supplies. So first of all, we're gonna have new reinforcements. It's a sniper, and then snipers and tanks gonna move. Sniper's gonna move toward the base. So let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So he's gonna move actually this way. So 1, the sniper, and the tank's gonna move toward the closest red spot. So 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. So tank's gonna actually retreat back. So the tank is basically patrolling this sector, which is not good. If I get a general here, I need to watch out, because if I get another unit in this sector, I can lose the game. Oh wait, rough terrain, I didn't see this. All German unit has -1 to movement. So if the tank was here, it still can get there because it has 3 movements. So 1, 2, but the sniper will stay on the spot. Because he can't move. Snipers can move only, have only 1 movement, and -1, that's 0, so he will not move. Alright, so I'm gonna use my soldier. I'm gonna sacrifice it, so I'm gonna move him. 1, 2, 3, here, closer to the tank. And then, since I have a focus, I'm gonna try a long shot on the sniper. I have 2 shots. Okay, this is not enough. I need a 6 on the focus die and at least 4, 5 or 6 on this die. Let's hope for the second shot. That's a 5, but this will only remove 1 range, so no. Because this guy have a 1, 2, 3, 7 strength, so long shots didn't help here. Alright. Let's continue. I'm hoping for that general to come out. This guy 1, play 2. Okay, I'm gonna use this and this as activation. So we're gonna have another reinforcements on spot 1. This guy is gonna move 1 space forward. Because whenever they get pushed, they move only 1 space forward. They get pushed by the DS soldiers that just stand there. Then every unit is going to activate. So let's start with the soldiers. So they're going to go to the closest yellow spot, in which case it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is the closest yellow spot. They move twice, 1, 2. Then the sniper's gonna activate, gonna move toward the closest red spot. In this case, this is the closest red spot. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, gonna move down. So he's gonna move once, which should push tank once. But since tank can't get pushed into buildings, this sniper can't move right now. He's basically blocked by this tank. That's normal, that's how this game works. Which is good for me, because, oh wait, actually it's not good for me. Well, let's see what will happen till the end of the turn, and then we will see. Yeah, so the tank gonna move toward the base. So they move 3, but they can't end movement on the building, so they move 1, 2, and gonna cancel each other out, but because the tanks get destroyed anyway, I get reinforcements again. Now, this tank didn't manage to move and stay here on this sector in the end of the activation. I would actually lose the game, because if you have three or more units on the same sector, you have a problem. So I was a bit... I played this turn pretty stupid, because I need to watch out where I'm gonna place reinforcements. I need to spread them up a bit, because I don't... If I have, as I said, if I have in the same sector too many enemy units, sector's gonna fall down, it's gonna be captured, and I'm lose the game. Alright, so enemies alerted. I have 3 shots and 2 supplies. I think I can manage to kill this guy. So I'm gonna move once, and I'm gonna move allies once. Now I'm gonna try to shoot this guy from here. He's on the open ground, has a 0 to the strength, so he's still 3 plus, but because of range, he's actually 4 plus. I have 3 shots. So first shot, miss, second shot, 4, kill. And I would need a 6 to kill a sniper. I'm gonna try. Although he's alerted, so if I miss him, he's actually gonna move forward, which is not bad. No, 4 I missed, so because he's alerted, he's gonna move, because he has a range too. If I was here, he would be able to shoot me, but because I'm out of his range, instead of that, he's gonna move. So he moves once, which is good, because on the open range, he still has 0. Alright. I think I'm going to use this as a setup and this as a activation. So reinforcements 2, got sniper here. Oh damn, lucky for me snipers are not going to activate this turn. Nothing's going to actually activate this turn out of enemy units. I have a Molotov cocktail, which is useless with that, but I have one supply, I have a focus and 3 shots. So for that one supply, I'm gonna move my Soviet soldier forward, and I'm gonna use 3 shots to try to kill these 2 snipers. They're not gonna retaliate because they are not alerted. So let's try this one. His strength is 5, actually, yeah, because of the range. Okay, this cancels the rage, but I don't have enough strength. I only rolled 3. So, my second shot. Okay, well, this is bad. I needed a 5 to kill him, which I didn't manage, so, and he will activate right now. Since I'm in his range, he has a range to shoot 2, he's actually gonna shoot me back. And I don't have that little heart to survive the wound. What I have is a concealment in this building, which give me plus 2 to strength, so I have a 6. So he can only kill me if he rolls 6. 5, that was pretty close. Alright, he missed. I still have one more shot, so I'm gonna try to shoot to kill that sniper. Okay, that's a 5. And this did cancel the range, so I'm gonna kill this German sniper. That was close. Need to be more careful in this end, because the game is in the ending stages, so I really need to be careful. I don't need to rush. Alright, let's see. Okay, I'm gonna use this as a setup. Yeah, let's do that. So first we have a reinforcement on 2, that's a soldier. Now he will activate and he will go to the closest green spots. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So he wants to go here. Now the soldiers move 2, which is good for me, Actually, I made a mistake. I made a fatal mistake. But that's what happens when you rush. So the soldier is gonna go 1, 2, the enemy is gonna capture me, and that's it. That's the game over. I shouldn't have played this. I forgot that the soldiers have movement of 2. I should consult the chart and maybe play something like this. Well, still would. Well, actually, I didn't have a choice. Well, I did have a choice. This wouldn't introduce reinforcements, and I would be able to survive. Well, because of one stupid mistake, I got captured and shot. So that's the end of Sniper in Stalingrad, 1942. Anyway, thanks for watching. This was the full playthrough. Now you know how the game works. If you like the game I make, please subscribe to my channel, and I'm always open for some feedback. Sadly, I didn't manage to win this game because the sniper represents the player, and whenever he's killed, it's an instant game over. It doesn't really matter for the soldiers because they are like NPCs. Thank you for watching, and goodbye.